America's women have served with distinction in our military, particularly over the last decade in the war on terror.
Everyone is committed to doing the job. They're fighting and they're dying together. And the time has come for our policies to recognize that reality.
That's why Leon Panetta, in one of his last acts as defense secretary, opened the door for women to the more than 230,000 positions in infantry, armor, even special operations units like the Rangers and SEALs. Former Army Captain Tanya Domi applauds the decision. She writes, America once again reaffirms its core values of equality and respect. And she says it's good for our military and our country, too. Retired Army General Jerry Boykin couldn't disagree more. He's one of the founding members of Delta Force and the former commander of Special Operations. He acknowledges that women have served bravely under fire in support roles, but he doesn't believe they're physically up to the challenge of serving in units that pursue, engage, and destroy a hostile force.
It is not the average female that will be able to do that. So it's a readiness issue, and no one is considering readiness.
This is the Army's physical fitness standards, and there is a double standard for men and women. For example, a 22-year-old male soldier is required to do 40 push-ups. A 22-year-old female soldier is required to do only 17. Now, the Pentagon has said if a woman wants to serve in a direct combat unit, she will have to meet the same physical standards as her male counterpart. But listen to the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff explain a caveat to that.
If we do decide that a particular standard is so high that a woman couldn't make it, the burden is now on the service to come back and explain to the secretary, why is it that high? Does it really have to be that high? With the direct combat exclusion provision in place, we never had to have that conversation.
I don't know if that bothers you the way it does me, but that's frightening. And that what that really is saying is, if women can't meet the standards, we will lower those standards.
Stay. Stay down!
And Boykin believes it will have life and death consequences, as the HBO series Band of Brothers so powerfully depicts.
Come on, Joe. You're all right.
That's why we give medals of honor. And if you look at every medal of honor, it's normally because somebody was trying to save a buddy.
Go.
Band of Brothers also highlights an aspect of warfare that another expert believes the Pentagon is ignoring. Retired General Robert Scales made the study of warfare his business as the commandant of the Army War College.
One of the things that neither I nor anyone else, I'd argue, in the military really understands is this so-called Band of Brothers effect. It's this buddy teaming, which makes up the essence of cohesion in small units. Remember, the American soldier really doesn't die for his country, and he doesn't die for the mission. He dies for his buddies.
And Scales believes the Pentagon owes it to those soldiers and Marines to perform an objective study on lifting the ban.
Units that are thrown together or who have bad psychology or that are poorly led tend to die in hugely disproportionate numbers. So increasingly, the weight of these wars are falling on the shoulders of this very, very small band of brothers. And before we break it up and reassemble it, we better be darn well sure that we're doing the right thing.
General Scales' two daughters are former Army officers and both agree with their father on the issue. This West Point grad and former Army captain who asked us to protect her identity also agrees with him. She completed two tours in Afghanistan and Iraq and at one time wanted to serve in a frontline unit. But she changed her mind because of the wear and tear her body took during 5 years of active duty.
I guess I was naive to think that, that I would be invincible forever. But right now, I have two small children, and my quality of life is degraded because you can only hold them for so long because